आपने कहीं बोला कश्मीर इज नॉट गाजा, व्हाई डिड यू थिंक ऑफ दैट पैरेलल एट ऑल?
बिकॉज दोज आर द पैरेलल्स विच आर बीइंग ड्रॉन. इफ यू सॉ द स्टेटमेंट, अभी आई थिंक ईरान के लीडर का स्टेटमेंट आया था where he is, you know,
clubbed the Muslims of India with Myanmar and Gaza, which is ridiculous. That was crazy,
which is also a trivialization of what is happening in Gaza. And around the 2010s, you would remember this, there was a certain there were these parallels drawn between the Palestinian Intifada and the stone belters of Kashmir.
In fact, the stone, the image of the stone is a borrowed sort of visual expression from the Intifada, isn't it?
Right. So, I mean, you can say that it has historical roots in Kashmir and whatever, but around the 2010s, this parallel was drawn because armed insurgency and infiltration, those were like, those had taken a backseat. This was the sort of mainstream resistance at that point, you know, stone pelters, young people, all of that. The politicians of Kashmir, this NCPDP combine, they had turned Kashmir into Gaza. That's for sure. If you
you're saying the NC and PDP have turned or had turned.
देखिए आज तो यूनियन टेरिटरी.
एक मिनट, आपने एक बड़ी बात बोली है. आपने कहा नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑफ पीडीपी जैसे पार्टीज ने कश्मीर को गाजा बना दिया था.
बना दिया था. अगर आप
कैन यू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट यू मीन.
2010 में मुझे बताइए, आज तो यूनियन टेरिटरी है, आज पुलिस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सेंटर के अंडर है, ठीक. 2010 में किसके अंडर थी? आई रिस्पेक्ट उमर साहब, आई थिंक ही इज द ओनली जेंटलमैन इन कश्मीरी पॉलिटिक्स. दैट अपार्ट, माई पर्सनल यू नो एडमिरेशन फॉर हिम अपार्ट, एनसी वॉज इन कंट्रोल ऑफ द पुलिस. तब किसने गोलियां चलवाई? तब उन्होंने ही चलवाई, ठीक है. 2016 में आ जाइए, उस टाइम पे चीफ मिनिस्टर महबूबा मुफ्ती थी, एंड यू रिमेंबर दैट प्रेस, दैट इनफेमस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस विद राजनाथ सिंह जी, वेयर शी इज आस्किंग द जर्नलिस्ट, जाओ जाओ जाके चाय पियो, डोंट आस्क मी यू नो टू मेनी क्वेश्चंस. These are the people who had made Kashmir into Gaza, and Prime Minister Modi, he has cleared this mess for us. He's done us a favor. अब देखिए अब क्या हो रहा है. ये जो mainstream politicians हैं, they are competing to be seen as separatists just because assembly का election है. Assembly भी क्या है, जो एक downgraded assembly है, एक simple downgraded assembly election के लिए, जिसको ये खुद municipality बोल के berate करते हैं, उसके लिए they are willing to radicalize an entire population all over again. Their rhetoric is like separatists, while the separatists, the jamatis, they are dying to be seen as mainstream. They are saying, humne to kabhi boycott kiya hi nahi, hum to jee hamesha election ki support mein the. So my fear is, aapko bahut sare log milenge Kashmir mein bolte hue, bahut sare aap video testimonials bhi existing dekh sakte hain, jahan pe buzurg log bol rahe hain ki kya hai, theek hai, chal to raha hai governor rule, chalne do aur 10 saal chalne do. Acha, businessmen have said this to me ki humne to abhi business karna shuru kiya tha, 30 saal baad humne abhi 4 saal business kiya tha, ab yahi same parties aayengi, ye log fir se mess create kar dengi, because they are selfish. For one assembly seat, for even one municipality seat, they will radicalize an entire population.
But you know how they say that democracy is imperfect, but still the best option we have, right? So ये तो बहुत लोग कहते हैं ना कि भाई हमें तो कोई भी नेता नहीं पसंद, ये तो सिंगापुर जैसे हम बन जाए, चाइना जैसे ना, we don't really believe that.
No, for a reason. Democracy is a discredited concept for a reason, but particularly.
But it's still the best concept we have.
Sure, but in the
what is the better concept than democracy?
In the particular case of Kashmir, my contention is that.
Are you saying governor's rule is better than these elections?
I'm saying the double speak has to end. The politicians, you know, this double speak that they do. I lost the train of thoughts. I was just going to say something.
नहीं, आप वहाँ पे थे कि ये separatist, they are the agenda of the mainstream is separatist, and जो जमात है, इंजीनियर रशीद हैं, अफजल गुरु के भाई हैं, they are talking more within the framework of mainstream politics.
I'm saying democracy should not be used as a vehicle for the propagation of separatist ideas, because Barkha, that is what radicalized our entire generation. हम 2003 से पीडीपी का रेटरिक सुनते आ रहे हैं, ह्यूमन राइट्स, ह्यूमन राइट्स, ह्यूमन राइट्स, एंड देन दे लाइक यू नो गो एंड एलाय विद यू नो बीजेपी, हम मतलब जिनको उन्होंने उतना ज़्यादा यू नो ये कर दिया था, क्रिटिसाइज कर दिया था. सो डोंट गिव अस दिस, यू नो, ट्रीट अस बेटर, ट्रीट अस एज अडल्ट्स. We can handle the truth. We've handled the truth in 2019 and with a lot of maturity. Acha, one thing, when the Prime Minister recently visited, you know, during the election rally when he visited Kashmir, he gave credit to the people of Kashmir for keeping the peace. He didn't give credit to the, you know, police yeah. or army or something. Yeah. He gave credit to the people of Kashmir because the people of Kashmir handled it very well. They knew that 370 is just a smokescreen. It's a shadow of its former self. Yeah. It doesn't really like give us any great federal autonomy or whatever. So the people of Kashmir actually handled it very well. These people who are coming now and saying, hum 370 wapas layenge and the like, they are infantilizing the people of Kashmir. Treat us as adults. We can handle the truth. We know what the truth is. Kashmiri bahut politically aware hai. Supreme Court ne strike down kar diya. Aap kahan se wapas laoge 370? Talk about municipal issues. I heard a couple of these, you know, mainstream politicians. They were saying, ye kya hai? Ye to ji municipal election hai. Kyunki ye to prince aur princesses hai. Inko kya hai? Inke liye ye bahut, this is below their dignity. Achha, agar municipal election hai, talk about municipal issues. Why isn't one single Kashmiri party talking about dog bites? Dog bites se log nahi mar rahe hai. ठीक है वो भी तो ह्यूमन राइट्स इशू है ना लाइक कश्मीरीज़ आर डाइंग एट द एंड ऑफ आपने पूछा वेयर आर माय सिंपथीज़ माय सिंपथीज़ आर देयर